Good morning, students. Today we will revise chapter 1, Food, Where Does It Come From? Grade 6 in Science NCERT book. In our first class, we clearly discussed about the topics are functions of food, variety of food, ingredients of food, food materials and their sources, edible parts of plant. So, all living organisms need food to survive and perform different activities. Students, what is mean by food? Anything that organisms eat or drink for their survival. The next topic is varieties of food. There is a lot of variation in the food eaten in different region of India. The next topic is ingredient. What is mean by ingredient? The materials which are used to prepare food items are called ingredient. Then next topic is food materials and their sources. The main sources of our food are plants and animals. First one, plants as a source of food. Example, food from stems. Example, potato, onion, ginger and garlic. And another one is food from roots. Example, carrot, radish, turnip and sweet potatoes. Then food from leaves. Example, spinach, fenugreek, cabbage and mustard. Then food from flowers. Example, cauliflower, broccoli. Then food from seeds. Example, rice, kidney beans, corn and wheat. Next one, food from fruits. Example, banana, apple, mango, grape. Then last topic is edible parts of plants. The plant parts which are eatable. Dear students, some plants have two or more edible parts. Example, seeds of mustard plants gives us oil and its leaves are used as a vegetable. Dear students, now we are going to discuss about the question answer. First one, define the term food. Answer, eatables taken by human beings and animals which provide them energy for various activities for growth and good health are called food. Then second one is, what do you mean by food habit? Dear students, any idea? Okay, I will say, answer is the habit of an individual owing to which it takes a particular type of food depending on its taste and availability is called food habit. Next question, explain the importance of food for living organism. Answer, food is needed by all living organisms for the following reasons. What is the reasons? First one, it provides us energy to do various activities. Second one, it helps in growth. Third one, it helps in repair and replacement of damaged parts of the body. And the last one is, it protects us from infections and disease. Then another question, what are the two main sources of food? What are the two main sources of food are, first one, plants, and another one is animals. Plants gives us, we get fruits, vegetables, pulses, etc. from plants. Animals, we get milk, eggs, meat, etc. from animals. Are you understand, students? Okay. Fifth question, define the term ingredient. Already I told, then I will say, the answer is the materials that are needed to prepare a particular type of dish are called ingredient. Next, sixth one, why should we eat cooked food? Why should we eat cooked food? Cooked food is easily digested by our body. It also kills harmful germs. Cooking increases the taste of the food. That is why we should prefer cooked food. Then next question is, make a flow charts for the preparation of ghee and honey. How to prepare ghee? The first step, cow gives us milk, then come to cream, then come to butter. Butter gives us ghee. Okay, already I have explained, no? Okay. First, honeybees collect the nectar from the flowers, then store in beehives and extracted honey. This is the flow chart for honeybees. Then next question is, which parts of a plant are eaten as food? What are the parts of eaten as food? The following parts of a plant are eaten as food. First one, roots, leaves, fruits, spices, stem, flowers and seeds. These and all we eat food. Are you understand, children? Next question is very important. Define sprouted seeds. What is mean by sprouted seeds? The germinating seeds at the initial stage when a white structure grows out from the seed are called sprouted seeds. Okay. Students, the last question is whether plants or animals give us more varieties of food. Explain. Any idea about that? Okay, I will explain. We know that animals give us meat, eggs, milk, honey and few other varieties of food. Already we know. Okay, then on the other hand, plants provide us a large varieties of food. For example, cereals, pulses, fruits, oil, fats, vegetables, sugar and a large number of other products. Okay, thus we can conclude that plants gives us more varieties of food. Are you understand, students? Are you understand the concept? Okay. Okay, students, I hope you all understand these questions. Please copy these questions in your classwork. Thank you.